Yeah, so this is how we get Tor traffic going through Burp, going through Firefox, or using Firefox via Burp, via Tor. So obviously Firefox is set to do a proxy going through 127.0.0.1. There we go, that's talking to Burp, so that's cool. And then we want to go launch Tor. We've got caps lock on if you prefer. Once you've got Tor up and running, it should tell you here which address details to put in the host and the port. That's those. Once you've done that, you can go ahead and tick those. If you don't tick that last, it won't tick itself. For example, if I do this and then I tick that, so it won't highlight. Just put that back in. And then should be able to hit hidden wiki now. Don't fucking want to touch any of this stuff. Okay, so let's look at skin cards. Okay, so that's down, maybe. Okay. Let me just go back to the settings because it looks like there we go. So it's not ticked. That's probably why. Here, this is looking, not getting any responses yet. Okay, that's not ideal. Let's have a look at this one. There we go. Got some responses back here. Response 200, and then it's loading up the JavaScript. Got some comments. Whatever. Anyway, onions going through Firefox, going through Burp, going through Tor. So this is basically the setup that I used for picking on those cryptographic guys or whatever it was called. So the other one was pushing DIR Buster through Burp through Tor, and that was quite simple. You're basically pointing DIR Buster at your proxy. So we want to just add another listener, and then let's just put it on like the idea, and then. Loop back on here. And then what you can do is in your history you can just view by port, so like 8088, and then you can look at all your DIR buster traffic specifically. Or if you just wanted the web traffic, you go 8080. Or if you wanted it all, you take it all out. It's quite nice if you spend a lot of time in Burp. Nice little tip. Anyway, there's Burp, there's Tor, and there's Firefox using it. So that's pretty much the end. Thanks.